Good evening, everyone. Welcome back to Twin States News. I'm Nicole Menner. Overcoming adversity is something that MSU football coach Joe Moorhead wanted to instill in his players early on. The Bulldogs were handed their first major test with that over the weekend when quarterback Nick Fitzgerald was suspended from the season opener. But Coach Moorhead said that his team is rallying behind Keaton Thompson, who will be starting in his place.
I think the guys have a tremendous amount of belief in Keaton, obviously, because of how talented he is, and they hear me talk about the culture of the program and what we're looking to do relative to the little things and accountability and discipline and attention to detail. One of the things we've been able to kind of build and foster is that idea of next man in. So I think on top of what KT brings to the table as a player, that our team has a belief that we're going to handle prosperity and handle adversity. And when you're hit with a little bit of adversity like this, you got to bow your back. You know, you got to get your chin off your chest. You got to stand strong and trust it. You know, KT's a very, very good player, and we're going to put him in a position to be successful, and you know, he's going to give an opportunity, and he's going to play great in the game.
And we're also just 2 days away from the Rebels' season opener, playing under the lights of an NFL stadium against Texas Tech, a Power 5 opponent out of the Big 12. Offensive coordinator Phil Longo has had experience with the Red Raiders' defense before. While he was coaching at Sam Houston State, his team tallied 6 touchdowns against Texas Tech. But Longo says that he's expecting a much different defense than he saw 3 years ago.
They have 10 guys that have started on defense back, and they've been playing in the same system for the last 2, 3, 4 years, depending on what year the players are. And so there's a lot of continuity defensively, and there's also a lot of confidence. And I know that improving on the defensive side of the football has been a major issue there, and they've gotten systematically better over the years. And I think this is what it seems to me is the first year they're coming back into a season with some really high confidence on the defensive side of the football, because it's probably their most talented group of defensive players that they've had since Cliff has been there. And it's also maybe the most veteran laden team that they've had on defense. And so those two things right now, I think, are huge for them. And they have a lot of confidence on that side of the football.
And the NFL has hired 24 full-time game officials from among the current 122-person roster. These 24 refs come from all 7 on-field officiating positions and help represent the goal to improve all aspects of NFL officiating. The league is hoping that this will improve consistency, accuracy, and efficiency among the league. Tiger Woods joins an elite list of 100 golfers for the second leg of the FedEx Cup playoffs that begins Friday in Boston. This is the second of 3 tournaments for Woods over a 3-week stretch, really testing him and his back. After his third worst putting week of the season in last week's Northern Trust, Woods slipped to 25th in the points race. The top 70 in the standings after Monday's round will advance to next week's BMW Championship. And we have a Williams sister showdown coming up tomorrow. After Venus won a straight set victory on Wednesday night, Serena did her part hours later, hitting 13 aces to win her match 6-2, 6-2. So now the sisters will meet in the third round at the U.S. Open, which is their earliest showdown at a major tournament in 20 years. This will mark their 30th tour-level match. The two have won a combined 30 Grand Slam title trophies in 8 U.S. Open singles championships, 6 of those coming from Serena.
Unfortunately, and fortunately, we have to play each other, and we make each other better, and we bring out the best when we play each other, and it's what we do, so I think we're used to it now. I never root against her, no matter what, so I think that's the toughest part for me, is always, when you always want someone to win, to have to, you know, beat them, and I know the same thing is for her. You know, when she beats me, it's she always roots for me as well, so I think that's just the hardest part.
It always makes for great TV to watch them play against each other.
Yeah, he was saying about Serena.